morning, friends. Peace be with you. I'm so glad that you're here with me today for children's worship. Before we sing, before we work and we wonder together, before we share what we did today, I want us to close our eyes for a second. I want you to close your eyes and I want you to breathe in and breathe out. May open your eyes. This morning, we have a special story. One that some of you have heard before. This past summer, if you came to any of my summer Zooms, we actually learned all about what we're going to be reading today. I bet you know what it is if you think really, really hard. But before we do that, let's sing our gathering song. So let's sing, "The More We Get Together, the Happier We'll Be." Can we try that one? Here we go. Oh, the more we get together, together, together. Oh, the more we get together, the happier we'll be. For your friends are my friends, and my friends are your friends. Oh, the more we get together, the happier we'll be. Excellent. Okay. The story that we're going to hear today is still part of the Sermon on the Mount. Remember, the past few weeks we've been hearing stories about Jesus and what he was teaching on the mountainside, right? The large crowd gathered around, and we learn different stories, different ways that Jesus was teaching us to live. Today, we're going to be hearing another part of that. Jesus, while he's teaching a large crowd of people on the mountainside, he's teaching the people how to pray. Today's story is all about the Lord's Prayer. Remember, we learned this past summer. We even made a video that we got to show in our sanctuary service and in morning song so that people can see that we have been learning all about the Lord's Prayer. You know, the cool thing about the Lord's Prayer is it is prayed all around the world in different languages. So every time we say it, every time we hear it, we can think about how people all around the world say the same prayer. And it's very special because Jesus taught us how to pray this very special way. So let's read now about the Lord's Prayer.
Jesus was teaching the large crowd on the mountainside. As he was teaching, he said, "When you pray to God, pray like this. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil."
Jesus teach us at the very beginning of today's scripture. It says, when you pray, don't say a bunch of empty words that don't mean anything. Think about what you're saying, and when you say it, make it meaningful. Have a purpose with what you say. Think about what you say. And Jesus gave us this as a guide, as a way to help us pray, even if we don't know what to say. This can be a prayer that we can use. I wonder what your favorite part of the story is. I wonder what your favorite part of the Lord's Prayer is. I wonder if there was any part of the Lord's Prayer that you might change. I don't think I would. I think I like it the way it is. I wonder when you pray this prayer. Where have you heard this prayer before? If you're in church or if you're watching church on the video on the screen, you've heard it before, right? You've seen our video. We made the Lord's Prayer. This week, our word is guide. Our faith word is guide. Why do you think our faith word is guide? What is a guide? Well, a guide is something or someone that helps lead us, right? It shows us the way. If we're at a field trip, we might have a guide that kind of shows us around to the different places. If you ever go rafting down a whitewater area, you have a guide on your raft with you, and they help lead you safely along the river, right? Jesus was giving us the Lord's Prayer as a guide to show us and help us to pray, to show us the right way to pray. And if you ever get stuck and you start to pray and you say, "Dear God," and you don't know what to say, you can always say the Lord's Prayer. You don't have to just be in church to say it. You can say it anytime, anywhere. It's a great prayer to use as a way to talk to God, because that's what prayer is. It's just talking to God. It allows us to feel connected and feel close to God. And you can use this prayer that Jesus, his son, taught us to pray, right? I wonder what's in our wonder basket today. Do you know what this is? It's a prayer journal. Why do you have a prayer journal in the wonder basket? A prayer journal is a way that you can write down prayers, right? Or you can write down those things that you want to pray for, those people you want to pray for, prayer requests. This prayer journal is a reminder to pray to God. To pray to God all the time. Doesn't have to be at church only, or just at the dinner table, or just before you go to bed. You can pray and talk to God any time of the day. So this prayer journal is a reminder that we can pray to God anytime, right? I wonder what your work will be today. Maybe you would like to draw and color like I do. Maybe you'd like to work on a different story, or write a poem, or draw another cartoon or a book. Only you know what's right for you. But why don't you go gather your supplies and meet me back here, and we'll work quietly together. friends, I hope you enjoyed that time. Like I say every week, I always love that time. And if you would like to share what your work was, you can have your mom and dad send me a picture or a video of it. Today, I began to draw, and I drew a picture of a girl praying. She has her eyes closed and she has her hands folded together. And it reminded me, this is just one way to pray. You can pray to God with your eyes closed and your hands folded. You can pray to God with your hands up in the air. You can pray to God standing up or sitting down. You can pray to God laying down. You know, sometimes I even pray to God when I'm driving in the car. I have to have my eyes open when I'm driving so I can have, but I'm still talking to God. I'm still praying. You can pray anytime. And so while this girl has her eyes closed and praying, we often close our eyes and put our hands together to pray. You don't always have to do that. So today, as we pray, I want you to pray how you feel comfortable. If you would like to sit down in front of the TV, you can do that. If you want to close your eyes and fold your hands like I do, you can do that. If you want to put your hands out like you're going to get a prayer and feel God there, you can do that. If you want to keep your hands in your lap, you can do that too. You can decide what you want to do today, but let's pray to God and thank God for today's story. Five here, five there. Let's put them together and we can say a prayer. Dear God, we thank you for today. Thank you for Jesus, who shows us so many wonderful ways to live. Help us to use your prayer and use your prayer always to talk to you. And now we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. All right, let's say our goodbye song. Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go. I'll see you next time, friends.